look, I'm really sorry about tonight, but something really urgent cropped up.
Don't apologise, Tony. I don't really mind doing all the things that you promised that you would do.
Mr. Reader, I phoned Tony and asked him to come round and see me. Well, I had to speak to him urgently.
Sally, I don't think this is any of your business. Tony knew that I wanted him to be here tonight.
Look, I've said I was sorry, all right? It couldn't be helped. Sally, I only found out today.
You found out what?
I'm pregnant.
Yeah, well, she's had a pretty lousy time of it when she was a kid, Mum. Her old man, he was a real no-hoper, and, well, he used to knock her around a bit.
Oh, poor girl.
Yeah, and, well, then she got in with a wrong crowd, you know. Mm. She had a really rough trot of it for a while. Well, that's why I'm trying to make things up to her a bit at the moment, trying to help her over the last few years.
What do you mean, the last few years?
Well, you see, Doreen, she's been in and out of the pokey.
The pokey?
Prison. She's out on parole at the moment.
Prison?
Hang on, I'll make you a cup of tea.
I just don't understand you, Kevin. After all the trouble I went through bringing you and your brother up properly, how could you get mixed up with a girl like that?
There's nothing wrong with her.
Nothing wrong with her? I suppose she went to prison because there was nothing wrong with her. What was she in there for?
Oh, different things.
You mean she's been in there more than once?
Mum, she's been in and out of institutions ever since she was a kid. She's never had a chance.
Oh, is that what she told you? She told me her mother was well off, left her own home.
Well, she did.
Then how come she's never had a chance?
Because her mother walked out on her when she was a kid. Look, people have been letting her down all her life. Yeah, well, I'm not going to.
That's all very well to say now, son, but what about the future? You want to go into business on your own. Who's going to do business with an ex-criminal?
Well, they won't be dealing with her. They'll be dealing with me.
Oh, that's what you think. How far do you think your father would have got without my help?
Well, he didn't get too far with it, did he? Oh. Look, I'm sorry, Mum. I didn't mean that.
It's all right. Just you wait till you've got children of your own. How are they going to feel, knowing their mother's been in prison?
Well, they needn't ever know.
These things always come out.
Well, who's going to tell them? You?
Oh, that's a very cruel thing to say, Kevin. I'm not the one who's been to prison. I'm not the one who's done wrong.
No. Doreen has, and she's paid for it over and over again. Well, things are going to be different round here from now on. So don't ask me to choose between the two of you, Mum, because if you do, I'm going to choose her.
I guess we ruined your dad's date, huh?
Yeah, we didn't have to take her home straight away. I mean, I was the only reason he brought her here in the first place. Oh, he reckons I miss Mum's influence at home.
He must think you're still a kid.
Yeah.
Well, maybe I ought to go before he gets back.
Go where? Look, you've come this far, you may as well stay. He'll be right. He likes solving other people's problems.
All right, now that we're alone, what the hell's going on?
Where's the bathroom?
It's through there.
Dad, she's nervous.
She's a damn sight more than that, mate.
I didn't mean to break up your date like that. And you didn't have to take Mrs. Jackson home straight away.
We could hardly
either.
Discuss this with her here now, could we? You sure it's your baby?
Of course it isn't mine. Look, we've only been in Melbourne 5 minutes.
Well, that's enough time for you to get into trouble.
Yeah, well, not this time, all right? It's Bill's kid.
Who's Bill?
Bill Harris, the guy whose house we got busted at.
Oh, that's where I've seen her before, isn't it? She was arrested with you, huh?
Yeah, but look, she wasn't involved. She was just living there, that's all. She got out straight away after the raid. She's been living with a girlfriend.
Okay, where do you fit in?
What do you mean?
Well, if this Bill is the father, as you say, why the hell is she coming to you for help?
They had a row. We're friends.
Just friends?
Look, I've told you, don't make a federal case out of it, okay? We've been out together a few times, that's all. It's not my child. It couldn't be.
All right, I believe you. What does she intend doing about it? Does she want to keep the baby?
No.
Do her parents know about it?
No, she was due to go back to them this weekend, but when she found out she was pregnant, she couldn't face them. I've told her she could stay here the night. She can have my room and I'll sleep on the couch. There's nothing wrong with that.
I didn't say there was. As long as you don't mind waking up with a crink in your neck. What's the second name?
Blakely, Sally Blakely.
Sally Blakely. All right, I'll get you a pillow and some blankets. Oh, Sally, Tony tells me that you'll be staying the night. Tony, I think Sally could use a drink.
Yeah, right.
Aren't you going to get undressed? I'll be turning the lights out in a minute.
I'll wait.
Are you scared I might get excited by a flash of flesh?
I was worrying about my mother, actually.
Why worry about her? She's outside. You're still in here.
She's on her own.
I heard that you could have gone with her if you wanted to. Why didn't you? Didn't you want to leave Fletch?
What do you mean?
Well, it's just that you and your mum seem very friendly with him. Or should I just say you? Now that your mother's gone.
He was just concerned about her.
Oh, sure he was, love. But don't forget he's got a key to this room. You don't have to worry about being locked in here with me. It's when they put you in a room on your own that you better start worrying. Oh. Caroline, I don't mean to tease you. Where'd your mother go?
Back home.
Is that where you killed your old man?
Yes.
Well, from what I read in the papers, he deserved it.
No. No, he didn't. He couldn't help the way he was when things went wrong, he just couldn't cope. He was weak. That's all.
Well, you had to help your mother, didn't you? It's funny, you know, thing that people will do for someone they love.
Is that why you're in here?
Yeah. We've made a mess of it, haven't we? I mean, your mother's at home on her own, and Sharon's up there in solitary. You and I are stuck in here.
Why aren't you in bed, Simpson?
I was just getting undressed.
Well, hurry up about it. Make sure it's your own bed you get into.
What a cow. No matter how bad things are, we're still better off than her.
Morning.
Morning.
How'd you get on with your future mother-in-law?
Oh, okay, I suppose. Kevin reckons she likes me, but she keeps picking on me all the time. Should have heard the way she carried on when I cooked dinner last night.
Yeah, I can just imagine her carrying on.
Well, my cooking's not that bad, Lizzie.
No, I didn't mean that. Mothers-in-law always criticise. Get that, will you, love? What'd you cook?
Chops and veggies.
Well, you couldn't go too wrong with that, could you?
It's through here, is it?
Mrs. Burns.
So this is where you live.
How did you find me?
My son told me. He doesn't have any secrets from his mother. Although I'm sure you'd like him to.
How much did he tell you?
Everything. Having made such a mess of your own life, I'm surprised you want to drag someone like Kevin down with you.